Well, here's the donor vehicle. We've got a 99 Subaru wagon. Just pulled it out of the weeds here. It's been parked about a year, cranked it over, fired right up. We're gonna pull this engine and use that in the swap for the 73 Volkswagen bus. Last time she's gonna run's today. There's Kelsey and Malachi. We're doing this for Kelsey's bus. The 99 Subaru is a good runner, so we're about ready to pull that engine. I'm just running it to make sure everything's been sitting a couple of years, so the car is pretty much toast. A lot of spare parts in the back here from other jobs, so that's going to weight that car down. We scrap this thing out, we're going to add a few bucks with some scrap iron at the salvage yard. Mileage 192. It's a fresh motor for a Subaru.
We got a problem here running the Subaru to just check the engine. I've got gasoline running out the bottom of the car here. I'm lifting on the pinch welds. I think we've got a return line on the gasoline tank return line that's bad, so it's pretty rusty under there.
Got the Subaru up on the lift here, gonna start pulling the motor. I'm deciding to pull the transmission as well. This Subaru transmission can be installed into the Volkswagen. The engine and transmission will be flipped around. Got the 2.2 Subaru engine that's going to be going into my daughter's 1974 Volkswagen bus. And before we put the engine into the bus, it's highly recommended that the high mileage engine, this thing's got 180,000 miles out of it, on it, and it came out of a 99 Subaru Legacy Outback wagon. So it's got, it probably needs head gaskets. We're going to put head gaskets in it. I had already replaced water pump and the rubber timing belt here a few years back when she was driving it. We fixed some of that stuff. But we're gonna clean up, get the oil leaks fixed, the front seal, rear seal, cam seals, and get this thing ready to pop into the back of the bus so we don't have any issues once it's on the road. Really wanna get that intake manifold off because I wanna get that sandblasted and painted. Everybody's got a sandblaster, we'll get into it. Keeping all the wiring, the fuel system, everything. I'll take some pictures, make sure I can get it all back the way it was. So let's do this. Here's a closer shot of the 2.2 engine. And the 2.2 designation, you can see down in here, it says EJ22. That's a 2.2 liter. There's also the EJ25 newer engine. That's a 2.5 liter, but this is a smaller 2.2. Plenty of power to push around the old Volkswagen. And so my trusty dog, Reese, she's gonna be helping out and watching along with the process. Well, here I got the Subaru donor vehicle. I've pulled the dash, crossbar, ducting, heater core, blower motor, all this assembly, even pulled the seat out so I got access. Just to get this wire harness out for the donor vehicle, the wire harness is trapped here behind the heater box. You gotta pull that out and unplug. There's two large exits here. All of this wire harness needs to come out for the donor. So I'll finish popping loose all the small connectors and pulling this harness. So typically on an engine swap like this, you've gotta remove the engine, usually the transmission, wire harness, computer module, transmission control module, everything to run the engine and transmission. So that's what we do here. And then I send it out to someone that specializes in cutting down the harness, removing all the unnecessary wires, and then taping back up. So there's just a few wires to hook up back to the 74 bus.
maybe could have used a pulley or a snatch block on here, but it's pulling. This thing is loaded down. I've probably got another 500 pounds at least of iron and old brake job rotors. Yeah, it's full. Here's what you do with a scrap Subaru. Oh, he's gonna, usually they go right through the windows. He's being gentle. Goes.